is up. No.
what
is up?
Amazing people.
I think, you know, it's been a year of 245 amigos that we've grown and built and gone on a lot of exploring around town, around Vegas, and different cities as well. Well, to play tribute to all of our wonderful windy days here in Vegas, I decided to come to our very first location on my very first video. And if you've been here long enough, you'd know that's here in Red Rock. So no, this isn't a backdrop or anything. I am very much here. This is the background of today's video, and I can't wait to go on a little throwback with you guys, answer a few questions, and you know, got my little drink to get this talk on. I asked you guys on Instagram to ask me a few questions that you guys had, and I can't wait to answer these. So like I said, you guys, 245 amigos and plus 40 videos later, we are here doing a Q&A where I get to answer some of the questions that you guys have had for the past year. So let's get to it. But before then, it would be nice to do like a little mashup of what we've discovered so far. So before anything else, let's get to a little throw.
So worth it. Like, and the air is amazing.
What's the password?
Bathtub jazz.
It is. I seem a little nervous there.
He's coming!
You did it! You lost, but you did it!
Los marcianos llegaron ya y llegaron bailando cha cha cha. Don Roche. 1950.
Let's show them. Oh, snaps.
Hey, homie.
So it seems like you can't make snow angels. The snow's too hard. God bless you, and adios, amigos.
Wow.
Stay awesome. Remember that you guys are the light of the world.
Be happy, be you. Stay smiling, stay dreaming. Your dreams.
Adios, amigos.
And seek discomfort.
Hey.
Wow, as you could see, it's been an amazing journey with you guys, and I'm so grateful for all of the friends that I have made that are continuing to come as well, and I hope you guys continue to be a part of this amazing journey. All right, and before I get to it, I would like to give you guys a little backstory, because obviously you guys know me from the videos, but haven't really gotten to know who I am. So hi. My name is Nayeli, and I live in Las Vegas. I am actually currently 27 years old, and I was born actually in Mexico. I was born in Los Mochis, Sinaloa, and so I am a Mexican in the American world. Gosh, this wind is something else. Oh my gosh. This is just so bad. All right, as you can see, my hair is up. This wind is playing no games with me. So as I was saying, I actually went into a Pentecostal church since I was born, pretty much in La Iglesia Apostolica, for those who know it. I've been raised there. I played the drums for a bit as well. I love music, so I just love anything that I can express myself and go crazy with. And I've been here ever since in Las Vegas. I've traveled not too much, but I guess that's what urged the craving of me being so adventurous and actually like exploring nature to its full potential. I went through my own battles growing up and everything, and I guess through those challenges and through my testimony, I actually was able to create this image in my head of life and something that I would always just kind of share with people and just be my own like common sense, but ended up years after years noticing that that wasn't just the common sense that everybody had. And I love expressing it and sharing it with you guys, and now what you know of the word of the day.
So today's word of the day is worth, strength, hope, and word fear, being overcomers, friendship.
Word of the day, it would definitely be patience,
persistence, so comment right here, focus,
Courage.
No trace. Positivity.
Exploring.
Consequences. Love.
Influence.
Dreamer.
escaping, expectation, season, expression, value, existence, decoration, transformation, antique, community, molding, footprints, reliability, tunnel, nation, purpose, observation, art, extraordinary, emptiness,
spontaneous,
reminisce, waves, or should I say waves? Hey.
So we'll get straight to it. Let's go and continue with the questions that you guys have had. Also, fun fact, doing this Q&A has been a battle. This is my second round doing this, actually. If you follow me on Instagram, you will know. I came actually for a sunset view for you guys yesterday. Whenever I recorded this, I came a day before. Man, I went on and on, did all the questions, answered it, wonderful. Come to realize, got home, the sound did not work. I was like, oh my goodness. So here we are, second trial, big time of trial, because second attempt, but this one is giving me no hope. So bear with me. I truly hope that you guys enjoy this question and answer, and I hope it's not my last one. I love answering questions like this and actually getting a one-on-one on the camera instead of going out and exploring. I love doing that, but if I can answer any questions that you guys have had, I'm more than happy to do so. All right, let's get to it. So our friend Drea asked, which also goes by Unpopular Passion on her podcast. If you guys haven't heard her, definitely go check that out on Spotify. But she asks, did you have this exploring and open mindset before you discovered Yes Theory? Now, those who don't know, Yes Theory are big YouTubers out, and they pretty much have a motto of seeking your discomfort and pretty much going and doing whatever you want to do that held you back or have any fear, and actually create something stronger in you. And actually, yeah, I actually did way before. So I've always been a very optimistic person, but I think exploring and actually knowing who Yes Theory was enhanced the person that I am today. So it helped me, though it wasn't what created my mindset. It's something that I already had, but I had a community to back me up that says, oh, Nayeli, you're not crazy. Like, you're not living in all butterflies and rainbow world that's like impossible to live in. It's doable with the right mindset. About 5 years ago, I went through a breakup, and it was something that then I recognized and reflected in myself where I was like, whoa, like, who is she? And so I went on like a little potato, like maybe 4 years back, I was like a couch potato. I wouldn't go out. There was a point where my dad's like, look at the TV. Like, there's no one there watching TV, and you're over here like not doing anything. Go out and do stuff. Well, little did they know, now they're telling me, hey, you're going out a little too much. You can't win. Through this time, I was actually getting a little bit more self-conscious in how I looked and looking down on myself and everything, to the point where I was like, you know what? I have to do it, and I have to do it now. And it was the point where it wasn't just like, oh, I want to do it. It was more of a mindset of like, I have to get this done. So I enrolled in a class into working out, and then just creating that mindset for myself about like, okay, I don't go out much, but I'm gonna try to make it a goal at least once a month, do something fun for myself, something that I wanna look forward to in order to kind of like encourage myself to work out, to look my best, things like that. So I started doing that, and month after month, it was amazing. And funny enough, when I started that mindset and that actually me pushing myself to do it, I ran into Yes Theory, which then created a community, which now I've met my best friends through there. So it's been a great blessing as well, and it's defined who I am because it's helped me enhance without being shameless of however I want to express myself or who I want to be. Now, Michaela asks, what's the most adventurous thing you've done for your channel so far? I would have to say going into that race car and actually driving that for my birthday. That was like an amazing adventure on its own. And honestly, any hike that I've gone to. Our friend Melissa asks, what is one adventure you'll never forget? Congrats on reaching 1 year. Thank you so much. I love like hearing from you. I think that's amazing. I love it. Thank you for, you know, seeing my videos. It means a lot to me. And yes, Ooh, thank you. We're reaching 1 year of many, many more to come. But to answer your question, I would have to say the boat ride. So that was my first time ever really going on like a boat that small. And I've gone to like boat cruises of like from the Hoover Dam and stuff, like not cruises of like the carnival or anything like that. It's been more of like educational cruises, I guess, like boat rides. But something like that where I was able to get off the boat, jump in there and try to wakeboard or whatever you call it. Now that was a true adventure for myself, and I loved it. I loved experiencing it for the first time. Now Dre also asked, what was your very first adventure? Now funny you ask. Okay, adventure on my channel? Here, Red Rock. It was actually first creek that I introduced my channel and actually took you guys on that adventure. Now my very first adventure in life, I would say. Oh man, hold on your horses because it's gonna be quite a story. So I would say it was like about 2 years or so, or three, I went to California. It was 2019. So I went to California for the very first time by myself. If you know me, you would know that I live in a very conservative household, and to the point where it's like we always travel in like groups, whether it's my sisters and I, my family, just a group of friends. We always kind of like travel together. I'm never really traveling by myself. Well, in this scenario, it was quite different. I was like, I really want to go to this museum, and it's just going to be like for like a day trip, or like going one day, coming the next, or just a quick vacation, quote unquote vacation. I wanted to check out a museum that was going on over there. And I had met a friend like 2 months before, met a person, and he was going to guide me and, you know, things like that. So then I go on my bus ride for the very first time. I've never gone on a bus ride before. Man, oh man. So this guy, I thought I was going to have the seat to myself. We went on another stop, and there a guy sits next to me. Well, we start talking, and we literally talk through the whole bus ride, probably like 5 or 6 hours. So we get to the bus stop, we're getting closer to it. He's like, oh, where are you staying at? And I show him like the address of like the area. He's like, oh man, that's really far from the bus stop, like where we're stopping at. How about you come with me to where I'm dropping you off, or like where I'm staying at, and then from there I'll go ahead and take you to like the nearest place so the Uber or the Lyft won't be as pricey for you. I'm like, wow, what a nice human, you know? Yeah, definitely, let's do it. So I ended up walking to where he was staying at, and then from there he went on the train with me, which honestly I did not know LA had like undercover trains. I thought it was like a New York thing, like subways. I never knew that. So I was like, yeah, sure. He gave me a bus or a train pass, and then he's like, here, like if you need to get around, like this is yours to keep. I was like, wow, that's really nice. So he got me into like the train and the last stop of it, and I was like, well, thank you, you know, so much for coming all the way over here. I treated him to like a coffee bean, and we just talked a lot more. We talked about faith, we talked about his life. He was a lot older, and so it was just kind of like life experiences for himself and something that I could learn through as well. So he actually waited for me to get the Uber and Lyft and then go on my merry way. But that was quite an adventure for me, just because it was my first time going solo. Now that I think about it, it's more like, girl, that could have gone way wrong, which it could have. But God is good, and he had mercy on me, and he didn't let anything happen to me. He allowed me to be with a safe person. So we actually still keep in contact here and there, and it's been pretty cool that that I got to meet a genuine heart like that. But it definitely felt very adventurous, because as soon as I got to my Airbnb, I hear like a knock at the window, and I'm just like, oh my gosh, like no one's supposed to be here. Well, come to find out, it was my little sister. So that solo trip didn't last much. She ended up flying from Las Vegas to California and joined me on the adventure of the trip. We went to go see the museum and hung out and went just explored a little bit more of California. So that was definitely an adventure. All right, another question I have is, what has been your favorite adventure so far? What's a place you still want to go to? Well, I think so far my best adventure would have to be anything that had to do with road trips. I love road trips. San Diego, I think because it's been the most recent, would have to be like on there, like on the higher ups. Never seen whales live in person, so that was really fun. Or getting to experience San Diego as well. I've never been, so that was honestly a really awesome trip that I filmed. Another one that is in my highlights in my heart and I can't wait to explore it with you guys would be Washington and Oregon. I love those two states and their nature aspects. It's amazing. So, Lord willing, I will go and film something for you guys as well and we can go and explore it together. All right, next question. Our friend David asked, top five shocking places you visited. That's a good question. So, the first one definitely would have to be the water park, the abandoned one. It was just so interesting to figure out like what used to be and now what it is. It's just so crazy to me that that exists and we can actually still go and explore it. Second one would be the Wheel of Misfortune. Now that one, although it's very messy, it's actually very interesting on the aspect of the art. So I think that when I went to go see it, I was very shocked to kind of like see it, one, be that dirty, and two, just be that free of like expression of anybody can go and graffiti it and away from the city. It's just a pretty cool like, attraction, I guess, to see just for a little bit at least, because the meaning towards it is really nice. Number three would have to be the sunset that we never even like thought we would get, because our aim was going to the Grand Canyon. That was our goal. But little did we know, life had its other plans. And so we ended up just driving. And as we were driving back home, we got caught into this amazing sunset. Just being able to see that and to be able to just stop in the middle of nowhere and admire it so much, that was just like an amazing thing that only like your eyes can grasp it, because no video can truly grasp what you see in person. Number four would probably have to be the -5 bar, actually, just because it's shocking for me to see all of this objects, chairs, like tables, everything created into ice. Like we've known about like ice sculptures and things like that, which are nothing new to us, but a whole like bar and attraction made of ice, that was pretty cool. And lastly, I would have to say Bryce Canyon. Just because I haven't been able to take you guys to the Grand Canyon, Bryce Canyon is like the closest thing I could probably take you to the view of it. Just the way of like how crazy it looks. And that's another one where you have to just go to see the beauty of it, because video just doesn't do it justice. And it's just so much to see there. And there's a hike in particular that we didn't get to do all the way, but we did start it. And so just kind of going there and just seeing all of these wonderful places of nature that Bryce Canyon has to offer, I'd definitely go again. And it was like a breathtaking experience. Now Kendall asks, where's one place you would love to go and film and visit? Well, long term, I definitely want to go to Greece and Switzerland. Those are definitely places that I would love to go out of the country. Different cave explorations and also the pyramids in Mexico, definitely part of the highlights as well. Short term, I would like to go to like Yellowstone or also the Salvation Mountain. Now this one has been on my books for quite some time now, but I still haven't gotten my way to go, but I will. I will film a video over there. I've been meaning to take some really cool pictures there too, so hopefully this year I'll be able to go and take a look and we can all go and explore Salvation Mountain. So it's not too far from me, so I shouldn't be lagging it too much to go. All right, sorry y'all, my phone kind of dimmed a little bit, so hopefully y'all can see me okay. Next question. Vinny asked, who's your favorite guest star in your videos? Wink, wink. Well, Vinny, if you guys don't know, he is Ben Visuals. He does amazing cinematography, like just anything that has to do with nature. I love watching his videos just because it like brings that mood of just like an amazing cinematic view of nature, which is just amazing. So I give him much credit for that. And though I love when he comes into my videos, I would have to say Matthew, my nephew. One of my nephews that I have, Matthew, he's been on one video of mine, but just filming with him was just so much fun. Even when he was younger, we would always go on little adventures together. And so just that bond that it's not just for a video, it's actually like a bond between my nephew and I. And just having him be a part of it and seeing him being as excited to film with me, I think that's what makes it all worth it. So I would have to say my favorite guest would have to be my nephew, Matthew. So hi, Matthew. All right, seems like the wind calmed down a little bit. We can just go back to plan one. We'll see. And with that, now we're gonna take a little step back from questions about the channel. And I actually have some personal questions people actually wanted to know about me, so let's get to it. So our friend Alex says, what are your pet peeves? Which, great question, because it honestly isn't too long, but I feel like I'm still young. It can probably, you know, race up from here on now. For now, I pretty much have four that are like my top pet peeves. One of them would have to be when someone's sitting next to me and their foot just uncontrollably like shakes. For me, like, I only do that if like you're going to the bathroom or like you really are not in a hurry. Cause when people do that, I'm just like, oh my gosh, like it makes me so anxious. I'm like, do you need to go to the bathroom? Like, are you in a hurry for something? You're like, you know, you gotta go. So that definitely would have to be like my number one. Number two, oh man, lazy people. I can't stand lazy people. I get so frustrated within myself that I'm like wanting to shake them out and be like, come on, like get up. So lazy people would definitely be number two. Number three would be arrogant people, actually. Like people who just don't care and just kind of like say things without the knowledge that you might be hurting someone else's feelings by your actions or anything. Like, I get it, we all have a right to say and do whatever, but it doesn't mean that it should give us the right to do that, just because that doesn't reflect well into being kind to people, you know? It's like, if someone's expressing themselves so strongly, maybe point your opinion, but like, know how to say it, not just like bluntly say it, or just sound arrogant or ignorant, pretty much. And lastly, number four, which I feel like it's pretty natural. I think a lot of people have this, but when people laugh with food in their mouth, when it's all chewed and stuff, I can't. I'm sorry. I'll be like, I'm gonna look away. You do your thing. I don't know. That's probably one of like my pet peeves. It's not high up there, but it is there. It's like, no, I'm good. So yeah, those for now are my pet peeves for now. All right. Now our friend Christian asks, what type of recording gear do you plan to get in the future? Which is a great question, to be honest. I actually have been getting my eye on a drone. I've been wanting one, but I have a vision for myself where I want to take you guys along to the exploring aspect, but like into a real vision of like a helicopter view where it's like I drifted down, and it takes a lot of practice, a lot of controlling. But that's something that I want to get up there and I want to succeed to do. And another thing was actually getting a microphone, because as you guys know, my goodness, like, it's Vegas, I don't know why, has gotten so much higher in the winds throughout the year than ever before. And so anytime that I decide to record, the wind just comes and is like, I'm with you, we're filming this together. And even though I don't cordially invite it, it doesn't need an invitation, so it's always with me. So hopefully this video actually comes out a lot better, even if there's a lot of wind going on. So definitely those things are my top priorities into getting, and obviously a camera, even though I've held it back so long to get it. And the reason why is because I like to just pick up my phone and go. Like, there's no need of like an extra SIM card or like batteries or stuff like that. But I think through the years, I'm gonna have to progress into that. And yes, my hair is quite wild right now. I might have to put it back into where it was. But yeah, so usually camera, drone, and the microphone that we got. So usually those things are pretty on the top, and obviously like the backpack essential things, and yeah, that's about it. Now, as we're reeling it back into questions about my channel, I definitely want to give a shout out to all of the places that actually took my videos throughout the year and actually used them, which was insane to me. I am learning, so just bear with me, but luckily the main things that I'm so blessed to be a part of is the movement MOVE. The MOVE Foundation here in Vegas, they actually invited me to talk about mental illness, which I honestly was super blessed to be a part of. They added me on their social media, websites, and things like that, so I was super grateful for it. Also, another one that I was able to be a part of was the Mods Museum. They actually created like an Instagram ad and also Facebook ads, which I didn't even see until you guys ended up sending it to me and were like, oh my gosh, this is actually you. And I'm like, oh, it really is. And lastly, the Slimy Time. That one with my nephew, the Slimy Good Time, they actually added my nephew and I into their website as well. So I thought that was really cool to start off the year and to be like, I'm doing something. And so I thought that was really, really cool. All right, let's hop back into questions towards the channel. Anakin asked, what's your favorite hike around Vegas? And honestly, the videos that I've filmed, I've only filmed, let's say, maybe like the First Creek. I've also filmed Cathedral Hike and Mary Jane Falls, and I have so many more to go with. But through all of those, I want to say Cathedral was probably a really nice one, but I love Mary Jane Falls, especially going in the morning and just getting that hike in and feeling that freshness, and the water was so cold, experiencing that cave at the end, all of those things. I think I would lean towards that, but my go-to for all times would be First Creek, because First Creek is just an easier one, and it's just something that I go to just to zone out of Vegas and to have my own peace of mind and just go there, because it's an easy route, it's a fast route, and it's very nice and calming. Now, favorite hike around Vegas that I still have yet to cover, there are so many, but I call it the Jumanji hike. My Jumanji hike is Gold Strike. I think that's what it is. There's a Gold Strike and a Gold Spike, which I think Gold Spike is a bar, Gold Strike is a hike. Always get those confused. But usually that is my Jumanji hike, because you have to climb down a rope on a rock, or you have to slide down somewhere. It's like a whole thing. It's like you walk for 3 miles and then you go and slide down this rock and then you grab down these ropes to get you down. But remember, there's gonna be like hot springs. You're gonna get towards the Lake Mead River. It's an amazing hike. You're very sore and you do your walking points for sure. Like, you make your steps of the day, but it's insane, because you gotta remember, whatever you do going down, you gotta do going back up. Kelvin says, ¿Vendrás algún día a Dallas, Texas para explorar? Well, Spanish question, Spanish answer. So pretty much he asked, am I ever gonna go to Dallas, Texas to go and explore? Mi respuesta es sí, quizás van a ver un video en agosto y espero que nos ayudes a, you know, a turistear un poquito más. And in all, I'm definitely going. You guys are gonna have to have a little sneak peek that actually those watching, you might catch a video about Texas coming up this August. All right, wind's picking back up, hair's going back up. I also got a message saying, when you're coming down to Arizona? Well, hopefully soon. I'm definitely going there just for quick visits, not really to tour around or explore anywhere in particular, but I am gonna go hopefully soon into the best coffee shops, whether that be Sedona, Flagstaff, Phoenix, Arizona, or like Phoenix, Arizona, or like Prescott. Wherever I end up going, definitely Arizona is like my second home, just because I go through a lot of church events. Before COVID hit, we went through a lot of, like, I would go there often just because of church events. So with that, things opening back up, church events coming back to play, I don't think I'd be much concerned about lacking going to Arizona. I think you'll be seeing me there going pretty often. And lastly, mis amigos, one last question by my friend Eric and my friend Eloisa. They ask, where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? That's a wonderful question, because I don't even know. The thing with me is that I love planning, but to a certain extent. I see myself and my vision towards a certain extent of what I want to accomplish, but never really, I guess I've gotten discouraged through the years that I'm just like, well, we have to go with what we can find and work with, you know, working on getting today right, that way tomorrow can go better, and so on. So something that I would love to see myself do though is being more into foundations and more events, into me speaking and helping people out as best as I can. Funny story with me is that I'm like the perfect definition of like, God will give you things that you don't think you can handle. Story behind that is that I suck at public speaking. I actually get so nervous. Even people passing by, you'll see my voice kind of dim down a little bit. I have gotten better than what I was before, most definitely. But it's just something that I struggle with so much, having all the eyes attention to me. It's like, oh my goodness, like, it gives me so much anxiety of just like, oh my gosh, like, am I gonna screw it up? Am I not gonna say the right thing? And just through the times of like this year, and this is only 1 year of me doing this, I feel like I've advanced a lot better and I've actually conquered so much more than what I think I would have done without doing YouTube. Also, funny story is that YouTube actually wasn't an idea of mine. The thing is, I wanted to do it maybe like from now to 10 years with the vision of more of education rather than adventuring. Now I see myself in 5 years still continuing to adventure that out, but perhaps do it more into like maybe now different countries, or like not focus so much on Vegas, but also just letting you guys explore different hidden places that you never thought you could see in the world. Like, you didn't know these things existed. So just bringing that out to you, saying, hey, like, this world is so much more than our problems. This world has so many beautiful things that you can explore, not only within yourself, but just your mindset. And just exploring this nature just brings such a different, like, peace in you. And that's what I want to bring out there. And I think in 5 years, just being a part of that a little bit more, and then just being more vocal and being more sure of like my talks out loud, I think that would be a huge accomplishment for myself in its own. So thank you guys for allowing me to have this platform and for you guys to see these videos. And I hope I did answer a lot of your questions and you got to know me a little bit more. I would love to continue to do these Q&As. And as you can see, it's getting a lot more windy, sadly. And maybe we could do a little run track of our windy moments here together.
So, you're gonna move along with me because we're working with what we got, and that's a tree.
But I'm always recording when it's super windy.
All right, we're here in Seven Magic Mountain.
And with that being said, mis amigos,
remember, you are the light of the world.
So don't let anybody or anything dull that shine. God bless you guys, I love you, and
adios amigos.